Hello folks and welcome back to the channel. Thanks a lot for joining me today. We're looking at the elephant in the room, shall we say, today. We're looking at none other than the Behringer 369KT. Yes indeed, the rip-off merchants themselves have come up with another clone. After reviewing the Clark Technic BBD, I was pretty impressed with that. And when I saw that Behringer were coming out with a 33609 clone, I just kind of had to jump on it. So, we've got it here today, and we're going to take a look and see how it stacks up versus the UAD hardware. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a real 33609 to compare it to, but I'm familiar with how they sound, and the UAD plugin is pretty close. So, does it sound better than a plugin? Let's find out. Alright, so the first thing I notice is the weight of the unit. It's really actually quite heavy. One complaint I do have, the knobs are really tight and they feel like they could snap off at any point. They're all stepped, but if you listen, they don't sound great. The bigger gain ones, the bigger step ones, they're perfectly normal. Switches feel okay, but these threshold knobs, my god. Right, let's jump into Pro Tools and have a listen. All right, so today we are using the multitracks from the latest Produce Like a Pro video. So for any of you that haven't seen that, Nolly and Warren go into Neve Studios and record a bunch of drums and see what kind of tones they can get in the room. I asked Produce Like a Pro if they would mind me using the stems because they were really well recorded for the basis of a video, and they were like, cool, as long as you give us a shout out and you provide the download link in your description. So, in the description will be a download link, and thank you, Produce Like a Pro, for letting me use the stems. Moving on. Let's have a listen to the software 33609 first. Now, to be clear, I've soloed the output, so you're only hearing the 33609 without the rest of the drums mixed in. If you notice on screen, the actual drum bus is muted, and I've sent the 33609 direct out of the mix bus. So, alright, I've dialed in the Behringer roughly the same, let's have a listen. Thank you. Okay, so I'm hearing immediate differences. The compression character is quite similar. Very slappy, very leather baggy almost. Kind of a little bit, not dissimilar to the CE2 and what that does. But what I'm hearing is that the plugin is a lot more saturated. Sounds a little more distorted, whereas the hardware sounds bigger and open. There's less saturation, definitely. But to me, I really like what that hardware is doing. Let's have a listen again. Yeah, the snare sounds fatter in the hardware. Let's try it in the whole mix, see how we go. We'll start with the plug-in again first. I really like what that does. Let's move across to the Mixbus. And let me just bypass the C2 and put the 33609 in. By the way, I'm referring to it as a 33609 because, you know, it's the 369KT, but we're not fooling anybody. This is the 33609, so that's more familiar to me, so I'll go with that. Let's have a listen what it does on Mixbus, and I'll dial it in to where I think it sounds good. We'll be right back. Okay, so initial thoughts there. I like what it does. Definitely prefer the sound of the C2. The C2 has this high fineness to it, but still has like this huge attack. The 33609 tends to crush a little bit more, even at kind of similar settings. So for me personally, if the mix required that kind of sound, I'd definitely use the 33609, but for the most part, I'm going to stick with the C2 and use it on drums, which is exactly what I bought it for, to be honest. Let's try it on the whole drum bus. Interesting again. To me, the plugin seems a bit more unruly. And even when you dial the threshold way back, it seems to, I don't want to say overreact, but overreact a little bit. It's a bit heavy-handed, whereas the hardware, to me, can be a lot more gracious in its application of compression. Now, as I say, I don't have a real 33609 to compare it against, but if I'm just going apples to apples, plug into hardware, I prefer the hardware, I have to say. And, you know, that may be a foregone conclusion of the video already. Maybe people would have thought that I was going to enjoy the hardware, but I really actually do like the hardware. It's I don't have anything bad to say about it, other than the shitty knobs, which do feel awful when you're changing the threshold. There's no good things to say about them knobs. They are shit. Make no mistake, if you're going to buy this Behringer, expect the knobs to be horrific. They may ease up over time, but yeah. Anyway, I'll zoom out and I'll give you some final thoughts. Okay, so final thoughts. Like I said previously, I really like what this compressor's doing. It sounds, to me, very, very musical. It's very slappy, it's very bitey. When you dial it up, especially when you engage the limiter, you can absolutely destroy things with it, which I think is great, but also at subtle settings, it sounds really, really nice. C2 kind of vibe for me. I think it's a great purchase. If you're in the market for a bus compressor, should this be the first bus compressor you buy? Depends on your use case. If you hear these examples and you like what it does, then yeah, sure. It currently retails at £470 UK, although it is out of stock everywhere until about October. I just managed to get lucky and I found one brand new in box, not even opened, off eBay for £440 or something. So I bid on it and I was like, let's go. So I got really lucky, but it is out of stock pretty much everywhere. But you can put a pre-order in. If you're buying your first bus compressor, I'd probably go for something more like an SSL style compressor. The Nikatronics Bus Cat, if you've got 500 series, is a great option. That thing sounds amazing. I had a Warm Audio bus comp for a while. That was quite impressive. Definitely did a thing. Or if you're looking to blow big money, then a C2, a Focusrite Red 3, an actual SSL, many options in that ballpark. But if you're looking at entry-level compressors, which sound great, this thing gets a thumbs up from me. It's awesome. It sounds really nice. I'm actually pleasantly surprised. It sounds really, really good. For me, I'm always probably going to set it and forget it, leave it on as a parallel drum compressor once I've got it kind of dialed in where I like it. And I think it's going to do a perfectly good job there. Now, do I need to go out and spend £2,500 to £4,000 to get a real Neve 33609 to do the job of parallel drum compression? No, not really. This does exactly that, and it sounds great, and it costs £400 and change. So, sorry, Neve, but it's a no. If you were going to use it as your main bus compressor, yeah, I'd maybe go with a Neve. You know, you're going to get that Neveness, whatever that may be. Listen, I'm trying to get my hands on a real 33609 so that I can do a comparison apples to apples between the two. But until that happens, I've only got the software to go off. So, you know, your mileage may vary. But my initial thoughts are, it's great and you should buy one if you want one. You've got nothing to lose. Thanks a lot for joining me, and for those of you that are not subscribed, which is about 90-odd% of you, please consider doing so, because it really helps the channel. I know I've said this before, and I'm going to keep saying it until you all subscribe. Please subscribe. Other than that, I will see you next time, and take care of yourselves. Be well.